Going back to hockey, if you take a look at the substance abuse and drug abuse of professional sports, hockey has been the least, right? Whether it's because you have to be in incredible shape, whether it's because they give you an enormous amount of vigorous training and workout, and then they make you take physicals, and it's very hard to hide that shit.
Yeah, that might be part of the reasoning.
Yeah, and you know, if you're a professional athlete, you're playing Russian roulette with your life.
Yeah.
If you're taking drugs, because your heart's going to fucking stop.
Well, look what happened, obviously, with Mike Richards. It's been something that he's dealt with when he was in Philadelphia, then L.A., and now it's affected his career, it's affected his life.
It's affected his life because the rumors, and I don't know this, I'm just telling you what I'm reading, is that he is addicted to painkillers, which is a very easy, it's very easy to get addicted to painkillers when you're an athlete. Because
well,
you're in pain.
Brett Favre dealt with that for years. He was very, upfront and vocal about it. He was addicted to beer and painkillers while he was playing in the NFL, and he was allowed.
But it's very easy to go down that path, Eric, and you know that because they prescribe painkillers for everything. Your fucking pinky hurts. Here, take this.
Painkillers are very easy to access. You're absolutely right.
No, but in athletes. They're in pain constantly after a fucking game. They've hurt their ribs. They've stretched a ligament. You know what I'm saying? And the easiest way out is, you know, Percocets or Oxycontin or whatever, morphine or whatever other painkillers they have. And it's very easy to become addicted to that shit.
You're right. I mean, listen, even the average everyday person, you go have a procedure done in the hospital. What's the first thing you get given to you afterwards?
They give you either Tylenol 3s or they give you Oxycontin or Percocets, which is the same shit.
Yep, you're right.
So it's very easy to become dependent, right? We're dependent on a lot of, some people are dependent on sugar. Some people are dependent on fat and fast foods, right?
Yep.
Athletes, it's very easy for an athlete. Not that he wants to, not that he's looking for trouble, but he starts doing painkillers.
Well, yeah, I think you're right, Frank. It's one of those things. Athletes, they take a physical toll on their body, and they need something to help the pain, and that's unfortunately what they generally turn to.
And
I feel very, very sorry for Richards. What a waste of a talent.
Well, they have to recognize, Frank, that pain management is as big as getting rid of the pain.
100%.
They can give you stuff to get rid of the pain. They got to give you a doctor or a professional to take you through the pain management. And a lot of people disregard that and get hooked.
I play a lot of hockey. I work out. I would rather fucking drink a scotch at 5 in the morning than take a pill. Than to... it's so easy. I remember I used to dislocate my shoulder all the time from boxing and some football. And I remember once the pain was excruciating, and I went to the hospital, and they popped my shoulder back in, and they gave me a bottle of Percocets. No, I'm sorry, Oxycontin. And so I take one or two, whatever it said to take, and I could still feel the pain. But the pills made me not give a shit about it. And I said, these are dangerous.
Mm-hmm.
I didn't like the way they made me feel. And I never took them. Ever again. So, it's easy to jump into that style. And I think that the professional athletes, the stress and the stress on them is incredible. And now that, somebody's got caught using cocaine, They should use this as Bettman's always been very proactive rather than inactive and made sure that he's always taking care of his family, which is the NHL. If there's any dirty laundry, to clean it right away. I think it's time, just like Bill just said, something very prolific, they need to have pain management other than just give a kid a bottle of pills.
Yeah, it's been a tough off season for the NHL. That's for sure. I mean, it starts with the stole incident in Vegas and the Richard stuff, and then the Kane stuff, and now the cocaine and the drug story.
But the Kane stuff, it looks like it's healing itself. that it was all premeditated bullshit. Her lawyer even quit. That she tampered with the evidence.
Yep. Well, listen. I mean, I'm not gonna, because I don't know.
I think that the police sat back. Smart. Patrick came very lucky that he ended up with very smart detectives. They sat back.
Yeah.
Wanted to see her hang herself with her own rope.
And she did.
Well, she did. But what I'm saying to you is that's why they sat back. They didn't comment. They didn't let anybody know. Everything came, you know, when they finally made a public statement about tampering of the evidence or the rape kit, that's when the lawyer quit.
Yep. And the lawyer quit one day after the lawyer said that he felt like the FBI should get involved because he doesn't know how the evidence bag got to the mother's house. And then there were all sorts of conflicting reports after that about how it did get there and who tampered with it. But all that being said, I mean, it was still such a horrible thing for Patrick Kane to go through. It really ruined.
Yeah, but he was very mature. I mean, you know, it's very easy. It's very fucking easy for everybody to jump on the bandwagon. You know that.
Yep. Yep.
And
the thing is, what I feel bad for Patrick is that, you know, if obviously, you know, this was all something where she was going after him and targeted him, you know, it really ruined what should have been a very a fun summer for him, is celebrating his Stanley Cup championship, and Patrick was the one that really suffered because of it.
Yeah, but you know, it is what it is. I mean, who cares? There's always another Stanley Cup. In the future, he should get on his hands and knees.
There might not be another Stanley.
Sometimes it doesn't work out. Sometimes you got to go 2-3 years of pain and fucking suffering and innuendo and humiliation for it to work out for you.
But it's not something you'd wish on anyone. It's definitely a tough thing to go through, right? So,
well, it's horrific, and you don't wish it on anybody who's innocent.